In this module, you will learn about taxonomic categories of living organisms. Our Earth is a habitat of millions of plants and animals, and new species are being discovered every day. In order to group these plants and animals based on observable characters, several taxonomists have classified them in a hierarchical structure that consists of ranks or categories. Every category is referred to as a unit of classification and is commonly termed as taxon. Since a category is a part of the taxonomic arrangement, it is known as a taxonomic category, and all categories together constitute the taxonomic hierarchy. Although the classification of living organisms seems difficult, you need to have a good knowledge of the characters of an individual organism or a group of organisms to classify them. This also helps you identify the similarities and dissimilarities among the same and different kinds of individual organisms. Organisms are classified using common categories such as kingdom, phylum or division, class, order, family, genus, and species. These taxonomic categories are also known as broad categories. Species is the basic rank in a taxonomic category. It is a group of individual organisms with fundamental similarities. You can distinguish one species from another closely related species based on morphological characters. Think of the varieties of mangoes available in the market, or the different species of rose in the garden. The next rank is genus, which consists of a group of related species that exhibit similar characteristics in comparison to species of other genera. In case of plants, the banyan and peepal trees have certain similarities, and therefore belong to the genus Ficus. Among animals, the lion, the tiger, and the leopard are closely linked, and thus are in the genus Panthera. However, the genus Panthera differs slightly from another genus, Felis, which includes cats. The next rank or category is family, which consists of a group of related genera with fewer similarities as compared to genus and species. For example, orange, lemon, and grapefruit belong to the family Rutaceae, or the citrus family. Likewise, the lion, the tiger, the leopard, and the cat fall into the family Felidae. Although a cat and a dog exhibit some similarities and some differences, they are separated into two different families, Felidae and Canidae, respectively. Order is the next category, which is a collection of related families. However, the number of similarities is less than that seen in a family. For example, the order Lepidoptera includes butterflies and moths belonging to the families Papilionidae and Tineidae, respectively. Similarly, families like Felidae and Canidae are included in the order Carnivora, while plant families like Convolvulaceae and Solanaceae are included in the order Polymonials on the basis of floral characters. The next category is class, which consists of related orders. Consider the two orders, Primata and Carnivora. Order Primata includes the monkey, the gorilla, and the gibbon, while order Carnivora includes animals like the tiger, the cat, and the dog. Although these two orders are different, they are classified under the class Mammalia. Phylum or division is the next category. Animals like fishes, amphibians, reptiles, birds, and mammals have common features like the presence of notochord and a dorsal hollow neural system, and are thus categorized as phylum chordata. Similarly, all flowering plants are categorized under the division Angiospermae or Magnoliophyta. The highest taxonomic category is kingdom. All animals are put under kingdom Animalia, and all plants fall under kingdom Plantae. So, as we go higher from species to kingdom, the number of common characters goes on decreasing. Thus, by observing the characteristic features of an individual organism, taxonomists have classified living organisms into different taxonomic categories. You have now reached the end of this module. In this module, you learned that taxonomists have classified living organisms in a hierarchical structure which consists of ranks or categories. Organisms are classified using common categories such as kingdom, phylum or division, class, order, family, genus, and species. The taxonomic categories from species to kingdom are known as the broad categories. As we go higher from species to kingdom, the number of common characteristic features goes on decreasing.